Hi children, welcome back. Okay, already in the last video itself we have finished this second chapter of your syllabus, that is animal life. So today we will discuss about the exercise part. Okay, so I hope you all have textbooks. Open your textbook. Exercise part, first question is choose the correct option or correct answer. The first question I will just read out. An oviparous animal. Options are lion, snake, cat and the elephant. Yes. Which is the correct answer? Oviparous animal, lion, snake, cat and the elephant. Oviparous means the animal which lay the egg. Among these four animals, which is the animal which lays the egg? Exactly. The answer is snake. Second one, snake. The first answer is snake. Then the second one, the number of stages in the life cycle of the cockroach is 1, 2, 3, 4. The life cycle of the cockroach has very short stages, that is 3. Answer is 3. Okay. The young one of a cockroach is called as pupa, cocoon, larva, nymph. Yes, last answer, nymph. Fourth one, part of the bird egg that provides food to the growing baby is called as, or is, first one is albumin, shell, cocoon, yolk. While discussing about the egg and the structure of the egg, I have explained you which part of the egg is going to provide as a food for the baby inside the egg and which part is going to provide as a security, or which is going to be act as a albumin is going to, just like a jelly structure, it is going to protect the baby and even it is going to give some of the food materials, and yolk is the material which is going to give us as, which is going to act as a food for the baby, that is yolk. Last one, yolk. And then next question is, okay, an example of a mammal. First one option is crow, frog, lizard, last one is a whale. See, mammal means which give birth to the young ones. For example, human beings are going to give birth to the young ones, and cat, dog, elephants, tiger, lion, these all are going to give birth to the young ones. But in this group, there are three animals are there, they are going to lay the eggs. For example, snake is going to lay the egg, crow is going to lay the egg, and lizard is also going to lay the egg. But only the last option is there, that is whale, which is going to give birth to the young ones, which is considered in the mammal group. Then the answer is whale. I hope you all are copying this one. Just I want to solve next answer. That is, next answer is, you just, you can copy it on this one. Okay. We shall move to the next main, that is, okay. Next main is fill in the blanks. Okay, fill in the blanks. Then the first one is next game is fill the blanks. The first question is, a nymph sheds off its old skin during the process of dash to become an adult cockroach. See, while discussing starting only, we have discussed some of the processes like hatching and the molting. Okay, hatching, molting, these were the process where in one process the cockroach is going to shed off its old skin, and another one, the hatching is nothing but the breaking down of eggshell, and from inside the eggshell the baby is going to come out. So then here a nymph sheds off its old skin during the process. That process is nothing but molting. We call that as molting. Okay, second one. The stage during which a larva covers itself with a cocoon is called as a dash. Okay. Coming to the life cycle of the butterfly, we have discussed there are so many steps in the life cycle of the butterfly, and where the previous butterfly will not at all going to look just like a butterfly, which is going to look just like a cocoon, just like a caterpillar. Here is a one step where in which stage the larva covers itself the whole thick shell. Yes, exactly, that step is pupa. We call that one as a pupa. That process is called as pupa. And then, okay, tadpoles breathe through their dash. Okay, that is gills or skin gills. We call them as a skin gills. Okay, I hope you all have copied this answer. Write question with answer. Then in the next video, we are going to continue the next question. Okay.